Noah warned them.
That's right.
Fulfilling the mission of 120 years of preaching.
Years.
The people pressed their way and was determined to get inside the ark anyway.
That's right.
Read quick, Noah responded, then give me the 20th chapter of the book of Revelation.
And the sons of men approached in order to break into the ark.
You listen, you ain't going to break in the kingdom.
No.
And it wasn't God's will for no one to break into the ark.
No.
You had to come in through obedience.
That's right.
You don't break into God's church. God's church is the only church you have to be born into.
Born into.
The word of God says you're baptized by one spirit into one body. The body is the church, and the church is the bride.
That's right.
That's why you have to be born again to get in God's church.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
And the sons of men approached in order to break into the ark.
Yes.
To come in on account of the rain.
Yes.
For they could not bear the rain upon them.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord sent all the beasts and animals that stood round the ark.
What?
And the beasts overpowered them.
The beasts overpowered them.
And drove them from that place.
And drove them from the place.
And every man went his way, and they again scattered themselves upon the face of the earth.
All right, 20th chapter of the book of Revelation. Let me get much of that as I can.
Now in Revelation.
Everybody all right?
Amen.
Listen at this now.
Revelation chapter 20, and we're starting at verse 1.
Yes.
And I saw an angel come down from heaven.
I saw an angel, a messenger, come down from heaven.
Having the key of the bottomless pit.
Having the keys of the bottomless pit.
And a great chain in his hand.
And a great chain in his hand.
And he laid hold on the dragon.
He laid hold on the dragon.
That old serpent. Which is the devil.
Which is the devil.
And Satan.
Satan.
And bound him 1,000 years.
And bound him 1,000 years. Hold it. 1,000 years to the Lord is as one day.
One day.
And one day as 1,000 years.
But so, beloved, be not ignorant of this.
Listen
one
at
thing.
This. Listen it's at this.
2 Peter chapter 3, and we're at verse 8.
Beloved, be not ignorant
of this one thing.
Of this one thing.
That one day is with the Lord.
One day with the Lord.
As 1,000 years.
You see, one day is one day to us.
That's right.
1,000 years definitely will be 1,000 years to us.
That's right.
But not to the Lord.
That one
because
day.
Because he's greater than us.
That's right.
All right.
That one day is with the Lord as 1,000 years.
As 1,000 years. It's the same to him.
That's right. Uh-huh. And 1,000 years as one day.
As one day.
One day.
So here's the Lord.
Amen.
Or an angel of the Lord.
An angel.
With a great key in his hand.
That's right.
The key is for to lock him up.
Lock him up.
And a chain in his hand. And a chain is for to put him in bondage.
That's right.
Imagine.
Imagine that.
The one that had the world in chaos.
That's right.
Time will come that he will be in bondage, for 1,000 years. Now, the significance of the bondage of Satan. If a thing is bound, it can no longer function.
Right.
If Satan is bound for 1,000 years, then during that time of bondage, the whole earth will have peace.
Peace.
Nobody
That's right.
will have the attributes of Satan.
That's right.
Because his power, his mental manipulation, his dreams that he give you, his urges that he give you, the wants that you will have, none of that. All of that will cease only for a period of time.
That's right.
During that time, the earth will go back to the way it was in the Garden of Eden.
That's right.
Are you listening to it?
Amen.
Are you listening to what I'm talking? Glory to God. Remember, before Adam disobeyed God, Eden was called paradise.
Paradise.
The earth would be a form of paradise. And one of the main reasons why God will do this, to give the wicked, who was once influenced by the devil, a taste of what it would be like when the holy is with God.
My Lord.
God is going to give you a taste.
My Lord.
and just show you what you will miss throughout all eternity.
That's right.
He's going to prove to you that not even the devil that you are so loyal to is greater than him.
That's right.
He will prove to you, I got power to bind and to loose.
That's right. Go ahead.
He will prove to the world that following Satan was all in vain.
All in vain.
So the Lord binds him for 1,000 years.
1,000 years.
Peace fall upon the earth.
Yes.
To give all the disobedient and wicked just a taste of what you shall miss,
my Lord,
throughout eternity.
My Lord.
Hallelujah to God.
And he lay hold on the dragon.
He laid. You better read from the beginning again, Williams. Give chapter and verse.
Back in Revelation chapter 20.
Are you listening to me today?
Amen.
Listen, God, viewers.
Revelation chapter 20. We'll go back to verse 1.
The word revelation means that which is revealed.
Right.
That which God makes known.
That's right.
All right.
And I saw an angel come down from heaven having the key of the bottomless pit.
Yes.
And a great chain in his hand.
Uh-huh.
And he laid hold on the dragon, that old serpent.
That old serpent.
Which is the devil and Satan.
He is not just called a serpent.
No. Old serpent.
I love to detail this.
Detail it.
He's called an old serpent.
Old serpent.
See, serpent means subtle.
Yeah.
Deceiver. But when you say old serpent, nobody's a more experienced deceiver than him.
That's right.
He's been deceiving a long time.
That's right.
He's an old serpent.
An old serpent.
What else is he called?
Which is the devil.
Go back and read that again.
And Revelation chapter 20, verse 2.
Yes.
And he lay hold on the dragon.
Hold it.
Dragon.
That's what I want.
Dragon.
You see, he's described in a beastly form.
That's right.
Dragon.
Dragon.
Meaning he's violent.
Oh, yes.
He's vicious. He's called a serpent. If you know what a serpent does, a snake, let's go to school today. The snake, whenever he kill his prey, he wraps around his prey, he coils himself around it and suffocate it.
That's right.
And then when the prey dies, he eat his prey whole. But the serpent never start to consume the prey from the feet.
That's right.
He consumes the prey head first.
Head first.
What is your greatest struggle?
Yes.
Trying to focus on God? Your mind.
That's right.
That is the part of you that the serpent attacks. Moreover, he attacks your mind more than he attacks your body.
That's right.
For you can sleep and the serpent will slither its way into your subconscious mind.
That's right.
And now when you wake up, you got to repent for something you done dreamed about that you should not have dreamed about. For the book of Jude says, ye filthy dreamers,
defile the flesh.
Are you listening?
That's right.
So Satan, or rather the serpent, coiled itself around his prey, suffocated. Satan coiled itself. And sometimes Satan appears as a friend.
That's right.
A close friend.
Close friend.
Coil itself means it get close to you.
Oh, yes.
And coil and suffer the godliness, the righteousness, the sincerity of God out of you.
That's right.
Are you listening?
That's right.
Glory be to God. I hope you can get this.
And he lay hold on the dragon.
He laid hold on the dragon.
That old serpent.
That old deceiver.
Which is the devil.
Which is the devil.
And Satan.
And Satan.
And bound him 1,000 years.
Bind him.
Bound him.
I told you nobody gets away.
Nobody gets away.
Not even the devil himself gets away.
That's right.
He's bound for 1,000 years.
And cast him into the bottomless pit.
Cast into the bottomless pit.
And shut him up.
Shut him up.
And set a seal upon him.
Yes.
That he should deceive the nations no more.
Now, this is not permanent. Notice it says 1,000 years.
A
space of time.
Right.
His bondage, his captivity during this time is not permanent.
No.
You will only have temporary freedom.
That's right.
I wish he was bound now.
Oh, yes.
I wouldn't have to preach as hard. In fact, if he was bound now, what sin would I have to preach against?
That's right.
But the devil is loose, and we all can say amen to that. Okay. He's a wild thing.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yes.
Listen.
And cast him into the bottomless pit and shut him up.
Yes.
And set a seal upon him.
Yes.
And he should deceive the nations no more.
Wait a minute. Don't just put him in bondage. Seal him.
Shut him up and set a seal.
Shut him up and put a seal upon him. That lets you know that the Lord really want to captivate evil.
That's right.
If you don't put a seal on him, he may try to get out.
Oh, yes.
Listen.
And cast him into the bottomless pit and shut him up.
Yes.
And set a seal upon him.
Uh-huh.
That he should deceive the nations no more.
Yes.
Till the thousand years.
The thousand years.
Should be fulfilled.
It's over.
And after that.
After the thousand years is over.
He must be loose a little season. Must be loose.
He coming back.
Oh, yes.
For a little while.
That's right.
For a little season, and we don't know how long that little season is to God.
That's true.
Listen.
And I saw thrones and they that sat upon them.
I saw thrones and they that sat upon them.
And judgment was given unto them.
Judgment was given unto them.
And I saw the souls of them that were beheaded.
My, my, my.
For the witness of Jesus.
Here you have people of God still in the earth after Satan is loose.
That's right.
Now. This is where your salvation going to be tested.
Oh, yes.
If you can't tolerate something trivial or somebody talking about you, somebody look at you wrong, somebody roll their old beady fish eyes at you.
That's right.
You are not ready in any form.
That's right.
To die for the testimony of Jesus.
No.
Do you hear
and I saw
what the word says?
And I saw the souls of them.
I saw the souls of them
that were beheaded.
That were beheaded.
For the witness of Jesus.
Will you be a witness to
for Jesus
to the point that you're willing to be beheaded for him?
Beheaded. That's something.
Or will you deny him?
That's something.
Will you say God don't exist because you're fearful of that blade?
That's right.
Because if you deny God, you will lose your head anyway, and down you're lost.
That's right.
This is why the people of God must be steadfast and strong now. And to be that, you got to have strong preaching that makes us strong people.
That's right.
Sometimes I read the comments on social media of people that hear us preaching. And many people say, oh my God, I grew up on that type of preaching. Many people say, where you been all my life? Many people say, oh, I wish you was around when I was young coming up.
Right.
Many people say, I thought that preaching didn't even exist. My man from another country wrote, I didn't know America even had that kind of preacher.
My Lord.
Think of it. What makes them say this? Because America is known for being religious, a religious scam.
That's right.
Play church.
That's right.
Play with God.
Play with God.
As if there's no repercussions for your play.
That's right.
The word of God says what?
And I saw the souls of them that
I saw the souls of them that were beheaded.
For the witness of Jesus.
For the witness of Jesus.
And for the word of God.
For the word of God. Now, the word of God, there's nothing in the earth more powerful.
That's right.
More right. More true.
More true.
Than the word of God. What you mean the word of God? The sayings of the Almighty.
That's right.
This is why man have labored for years to contaminate whatever God says.
That's right.
He tried to make books to prove that there's scriptural contradictions. There's no contradiction, only the man don't understand the wisdom and knowledge of the Most High.
That's right.
But man will labor around the clock.
Oh, yes, he will.
Preachers will refer to great historians and black activists.
Yeah.
and will honor what they say.
That's right.
Above honoring what God says.
The law of the Lord is perfect.
Do you hear it?
In Psalms 19 and at verse 7.
The law
of the Lord, is perfect.
Martin Luther King was good, but he ain't good enough.
Not good enough.
Malcolm X was good, but he ain't good enough.
That's right.
Noble Drew Ali was good, but he ain't good enough.
That's right.
James Baldwin, good debater, intelligent mind, not better than the mind of God.
Oh, no.
So you can dig these men up in history.
Oh, yes.
Who's recognized in the earth for their greatness.
Yes.
And their brilliance. But who in the world is more brilliant than the God of heaven?
That's right.
The Bible says, who by searching
can find out
can
God.
Find out God.
Can find out God.
What man can hang the earth on nothing?
On nothing.
Nobody.
Nobody.
So the intelligence of God is not respected and have been dwindled down to nothing until man is so dumb and ignorant, he get a little bit education. A little bit education.
Just a little bit.
Get an LLD, a PhD, a master's, and a bachelor's. And then you think he's so smart. Oh, man, there ain't no God.
That's right.
This is one of the most ignorant sayings. I'm my own man. Yeah. I'm my own woman. You are?
You are.
Well, America proved to you you're not your own, because when you go to jail, if you're your own, then why don't you get out on your own?
Amen.
When you're hooked up to a respirator, you can't detach yourself. When are you going to realize your entire being is in the hands of your creator?
That's right.
And you have no power over yourself but the Lord of creation.
That's right.
And when these religious leaders stop trying to make themselves God, equal to the God of the universe. You know, religions quote the scripture in the Old Testament that says, ye are gods. Oh, man, people are running wild with that. The Hebrew Israelites are running around with it. The Nation of Islam running wild with it. They quote that scripture. Ye are gods.
Ye are gods.
And they put too much emphasis. Oh, I'm a god.
That's right.
I'm a god. Here's a god over there, a drunken god.
Here's a
high weed smoking god. Here's a woman beating god, a cussing god, a lying god. You have nothing but the title God,
that's
which
right.
shows you are made in the image of God.
That's it.
Now, the image of God is not just the shape of the creator, but God wants you to have his character.
Character, that's it.
But the only thing you got is God's image, but you don't have God's character. You are God equal to the God of this world, Satan.
Satan.
Are you listening?
In Psalms 82 and at verse 6.
What is it?
I have said, ye are gods.
I have said,
ye are gods.
Ye are gods. But what good is it, William?
And all of you are children.
All of you are children.
Of the Most High.
Of the Most High.
But ye shall die.
But when it's time for death,
ye shall die.
You
like
shall
men.
Die like men.
And fall like one of the princes.
And you're going to fall like one of the princes.
That's right.
So you can walk around and I'm God.
Amen.
I'm God.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
And I saw the souls of them that were beheaded for the witness of Jesus and for the word of God.
Yeah.
And which had not worshipped the beast, neither his image.
Real quick.
Neither had received his mark upon their foreheads or in their hands.
Yes.
And they lived and reigned with Christ 1,000 years.
They reigned with Christ for 1,000 years. Now, a term that describes 1,000 years, which also is called millennium.
Millennium.
This is where you get the phrase millennium reign. See, while Satan is in bondage and peace on earth, the millennium reign starts when the Lord comes and present unto himself his glorious church. The church will be with God. Satan will be bound. There'll be peace on earth. The only ones left on earth while the church is with the Lord is two classes of people.
That's right.
Wicked and righteous.
And righteous.
The holy is already gone.
Right.
Blessed
and holy,
and holy is he
that hath part in the first
resurrection on such the second death
has
no power. So when God come, the Lord come, Jesus come, Christ come, Jehovah come, I am that I am when he come.
That's right.
With a shout, that don't mean he gonna come jumping. Shout is his voice. His voice is described shout. His voice is described as the voice of an archangel.
For the Lord
His voice is described as a trump of God. Guess you get some Bible, son.
1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and read verse 16.
Oh, this is good.
For the Lord himself.
Who doing it?
The Lord himself.
Hold it. Let's get the Lord's name. Acts 9:5.
And he said, who art thou,
Lord? And you better give me Psalms chapter 100 and verse 3.
Amen.
I preach that Jesus Christ is God. Yes, I do.
Yes, you
for
do.
The Bible said the Lord himself
the Lord
shall
himself.
Descend from heaven with a shout. Let's get the Lord's name in Acts chapter 9 and verse 5.
And he said, who art thou, Lord?
Who art thou, Lord?
And the Lord said.
And the Lord said.
I am Jesus.
Let's get the Lord who he admit that he is in Psalms 100 and verse 3.
Know ye the Lord.
Know ye the Lord.
That he is God.
That he is God. God, give me Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 5. Let's
one
see
Lord,
how many lords it is.
One Lord.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. One Lord. One. One Lord. Just one. Glory to God. Just one. That one Lord say he's Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
That one Lord Hallelujah. Says my name is Jesus.
Hallelujah.
That one Lord said he's God.
Hallelujah.
And then he says the Lord himself.
Shall
now, you may ask,
Hallelujah.
All right, if the Lord is Jesus and the Lord is coming back, who gonna be on the throne? God is.
Hallelujah.
Well, I thought God is coming back. That's true. And he gonna be on the throne? Yes, God say I'm higher than heaven.
Higher than heaven.
I'm broader than the earth.
That's right.
I'm deeper than hell. God is everywhere.
Everywhere.
God Almighty is everywhere.
Everywhere.
He's in Africa. Why, he's here in America. He's in Canada. Why, he's somewhere else in the world.
That's right.
He's in us while he's in heaven.
It is as high as heaven.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The head.
Job chapter 11 and at verse 8.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
What did he say, son?
It is as high as heaven.
It is as high. Glory to God as heaven.
What canst thou do?
What can you do?
Deeper than hell.
Deeper than hell.
What canst thou know?
What can you know?
The measure thereof is longer than the earth.
The measure thereof is longer than the earth.
And broader than the sea.
Broader than the sea.
If he cut off.
Oh, you glory to God.
Hallelujah.
God says.
If he cut off.
If he cut you off.
And shut up.
And shut you up.
Or gather together.
Or gather together.
Then who can hinder him?
Who can stop him?
That's right.
Who can stop him?
That's right.
Who can tell God what to do and what not to do?
That's right.
God answers to no man.
Amen.
But all men must answer to God.
That's right. That's right.
Are you listening?
For the Lord himself.
The Lord. Hallelujah. Glory
hallelujah.
To God. The Lord
himself.
That's plain.
That's plain.
That's plain.
Oh, yes.
The Lord himself
shall descend from heaven with a shout.
Shall descend from heaven
with a shout.
With a shout.
With the voice of the archangel.
This is what his voice going to sound like.
With the voice of the archangel.
With the voice of an archangel.
And with the trump of God.
With the trump of God. And.
And the dead in Christ.
The dead in Christ.
Shall rise first.
Rise when?
First.
Second.
First.
Third.
First.
Fourth.
First. Hallelujah.
That's the real first resurrection.
Go ahead, brother. That's right. Hallelujah.
What the nation of Islam call the first resurrection, there ain't no first resurrection.
No. The dead in Christ shall rise first.
What the nation of Islam call while Elijah Muhammad was living,
hallelujah.
And you that was alive when he was alive, you call that the first resurrection. Man, there ain't no first resurrection.
Oh, no. No way. Hallelujah. Go ahead, brother.
A Muslim challenged me and said that the coming of Elijah Muhammad was prophesied in the book of Micah. They say Elijah will come.
Hmm.
All right. Give me the book of Malachi.
Malachi.
And then I believe give me the book of John or Luke in the New Testament.
Yeah.
Let me show you who was Elijah.
That's right.
See, I love to dissect the Bible.
Yes.
Amen. All my information is right in the Bible.
That's right.
All right, son, look at what it says.
In the book of Malachi, chapter 4.
I'm going to prove to you that the book of Malachi was not talking about the coming of Elijah Muhammad.
That's right.
Because Elijah already came and dead.
That's right.
But somebody had to come look like him, sound like him, represent him so close until he had come in the likeness of the Old Testament prophet.
That's right.
All right, son, listen at this.
Malachi, chapter 4, and right verse 5.
I have many of ex-Nation of Islam brothers here.
Mm-hmm.
Whole lot of them. I have brothers here that used to be Sunni Muslims. I have sisters here that used to be Nation of Islam and Sunni Muslims used to be part of the Nation of Islam MGT staff.
Amen.
But when they heard holy. When they heard be holy.
Be holy.
Be holy is not be Muslim.
No, it's not.
Be holy is not be a Jew.
No.
Be holy is not go after Christianity.
That's right.
Be holy means be like God.
Be like God.
Whatever God said.
That's right.
Follow it.
That's right.
To the letter.
Go ahead.
All right, let's get Elijah, son. Then we go back to Revelation.
Malachi chapter 4 and we're at verse 5.
Yeah, man.
Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet.
Ha.
Amen.
Behold,
I will send you Elijah the prophet.
I will send Elijah
the prophet.
The prophet.
Before the coming of the great and dreadful
before
day of the Lord.
Before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord.
And he shall turn the heart.
He shall turn the hearts
of the fathers
of
to the
fathers
children.
To the children.
And the heart of the children
and
to
the
their fathers.
And the children's
father.
Heart to the mother.
To their fathers.
To their fathers.
Lest I come and smite the earth with a curse.
All right, they say that was the fourth prophecy of the arrival of Elijah Muhammad.
Yes.
All right, let's see what the Bible says.
Now in the book of St. Luke.
Now this is what I take.
Amen. St. Luke chapter 1.
I take what the word of God says.
That's right.
And when I take what the word of God says, it debunks what everybody else said.
That's right.
Everybody.
Everybody.
It debunks what Farad Muhammad says. It debunks what Elijah Muhammad says.
That's right.
It debunks what Farrakhan says.
That's right.
Remember, the prophet declared that
Elijah
I will send Elijah.
The prophet.
The prophet.
Before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord.
At no time did he say, I will send Elijah Muhammad.
No, it didn't. No, it didn't.
Didn't say that.
Elijah the prophet.
But I will send Elijah.
I will send you Elijah the prophet.
The prophet or Elijah the messenger.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
Before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord.
Yes.
And he shall turn the heart of the fathers to the children.
And
the heart of the children to their fathers.
And
lest I come and smite the earth with a curse.
Let us see.
Amen.
Who fulfilled this?
Now in the book of St. Luke chapter 1. And we're going to start reading at verse 13.
Listen.
Amen.
I love this.
Amen.
Give chapter and verse again.
St. Luke chapter 1, and we'll start reading at verse 13.
Follow me in your Bible.
St. Luke chapter
follow
1.
Follow me in the scriptures.
And verse 13.
Follow me in the book of truth.
That's right.
Says what?
But the angel said unto him, fear not, Zacharias.
The angel said unto him,
fear not, Zacharias.
Fear not, Zacharias.
Thy prayer is heard.
Thine prayer is heard.
And thy wife Elizabeth shall bear thee a son.
Thy wife Elizabeth
shall bear thee a son.
Will bear thee a son.
And thou shalt call his name John.
Thou shalt call his name John.
And thou shalt have joy and gladness, and many shall rejoice at his birth.
You're going to be happy about him.
For he shall be great in the sight of the
he
Lord.
He shall be great in God's eyes.
And shall drink neither wine nor strong drink.
And what?
And he shall be filled with the Holy Ghost even from his mother's womb.
Yes.
And many of the children of Israel.
Hold it.
Amen.
Many of the children of Israel.
Shall he turn to the Lord their God.
Shall he turn to the Lord.
And at St. Luke 1 now, we're at verse 17.
Yes.
And he shall go before him.
He shall go before him.
In the spirit.
In the spirit.
And power.
And power.
Of Elias.
Of Elias.
To turn the hearts of the fathers.
He's going
to
turn the hearts of the fathers.
To the children.
To the children.
And the disobedient.
And the disobedient.
To the wisdom of the just.
That was John.
John.
Not Elijah Poole.
That's right. That's right.
That was John the Baptist.
John, that's right.
And what else did he say?
And he shall go before him in the spirit and power of Elias.
Yes.
To turn the hearts of the fathers to the children.
Yes.
And the disobedient to the wisdom of the just.
Yes.
To make ready a people prepared.
And make ready a people prepared
for the Lord.
For the Lord.
Amen.
Isn't that wonderful?
That's wonderful.
The Bible always debunks.
Always.
The sayings of men. Men right. always try to hijack prophecies.
That's right.
And make it him.
That's right.
Have you noticed that?
Yes.
There's some fellow, I believe it, in Puerto Rico and the Philippines that says he's the second coming of Christ.
My Lord, my Lord.
That man, I don't know what he's smoking.
He's smoking something.
Whatever he's smoking, man, it is working big time.
It's got him high, Pastor.
It got him very high.
Amen.
Believe he the second coming of Christ.
My Lord, my Lord.
The danger is people believes it.
Yeah.
People are brainwashed by it.
Oh, yes.
And people are loyal to it. You better give me more revelation, son. I got to finish up real quick.
Back in Revelation chapter 20, and we'll start at verse 4 again.
Yes.
And I saw thrones and they that sat upon them, and judgment was given unto them. And I saw the souls of them that were beheaded for the witness of Jesus and for the word of God.
Yes.
And which had not worshipped the beast, neither his image, neither had received his mark upon their foreheads or in their hands.
Yes.
And they lived and reigned with Christ 1,000 years.
1,000 years.
But the rest of the dead lived not again.
Look at here. The rest of the dead didn't live again.
Until the 1,000 years were finished.
Until the millennium come to an end.
This is the first resurrection.
This is.
That's it.
Church is with the Lord.
Amen.
This. Nothing else.
That's right.
Glory to God. This.
This is the first resurrection.
That's what we're waiting for.
That's right.
The first resurrection.
First resurrection.
Be quick.
Blessed and holy is he.
What kind?
Blessed and
Baptist is he.
Holy is he.
Blessed. And Hebrew Israelite is he.
Blessed and holy is he.
Blessed and African is he.
Blessed and holy is he.
Blessed and white is he.
Blessed and holy is he.
Blessed and Buddhist is he.
Blessed and holy is he.
Blessed and skinhead is he.
Blessed and holy is he.
You see how the Bible don't call for nothing else?
That's right.
And you out there try to make this mind religion, mind religion, mine.
Amen.
I often think of the commercial when I was a kid of the Gino's restaurant. Everybody go to Gino's. Mm-hmm. Gino's is a place to go. That may be a restaurant, but it's not my church.
No.
Jesus said, upon this rock I'll build my church.
My church.
And the gates of hell shall not prevail against it.
That's right.
Amen. This is his church.
That's right.
I am just a member in his church.
That's it.
And I happen to work for him in his church.
Amen.
All right.
Blessed and holy is he that hath...
Blessed...
Amen.
You got to be a fool not to want to be blessed.
That's right.
Not to want to be holy.
That's right.
Blessed.
And holy is he.
Being holy. And holy.
Is he.
Is he.
That hath part.
That hath part.
In the first resurrection.
On such.
The second death.
The second death.
Has no power.
In order to make the first resurrection, you got to get it right now.
That's right.
So you might as well endure what I'm preaching.
That's right.
Get mad at me and let the madness just go away eventually, but you might as well come on and do what it said.
Come on, do what it says.
To make the first, listen, in order to get to the airport, everybody got to go through that customs and or whatever, and where to examine you. And
yeah.
What is that called? TSA, everybody got to go through there.
Go through there.
If your belt make the thing beep, you got to take it off, and hopefully your pants don't fall.
That's right.
Whenever I go through the airport, I know what's going to happen because, you know, I always wear suspenders on my pants. Mm-hmm. And when I go through, the moment I get through, I hold my arms out and say, suspenders. They say, well, you've been through here quite a bit. And sometimes some of the TSA recognize me. They say, he all right. That's Pastor Jennings. He all right. He ain't smuggling nothing but the Bible.
Amen.
Yeah? Amen. I remember one man was patting me down, examining me, see, Pastor Jennings, I know you ain't got nothing, but I'm just going through the motion. I want to ask you some Bible questions. I said, that's why you pat me down. He said, man, look, I got to take this time and use it to my advantage. He started asking about the baptism in the name of Jesus Christ. He said, did you really got to be baptized? I said, yes. You got to have it.
Amen.
I had my arms out. I had my hands out.
Wonderful.
Amen. I'm telling you, people, you got to get the thing like God itemized.
That's right.
The world is listening. Mm-hmm. And many that used to fight it, now they're starting to come around. You will realize I pray, God, that you better pray. You don't be like those when the rain came in the days of Noah and not even God will hear them.
That's right.
You want God to hear you, you better obey him right now.
Right now.
All right, read quick, son.
Blessed and holy is he that hath part in the first resurrection.
Blessed and holy is he that hath part in the first resurrection, on such a second death.
Hath no power.
Have no power.
But they shall
preach. For they shall,
be priests,
of God. Meaning they shall be royalty. A peculiar people, a royal priesthood.
Go ahead, man. But they shall be priests of God and of Christ.
The reason why they're going to be priests of God and of Christ, they're going to be priests of God and of Christ, mean they're going to be God's anointed.
That's right. And shall reign with him 1,000 years.
Reign with them.
Him.
Them.
Him.
Them.
And shall reign with him.
We only going to be with one.
That's it.
You that got more than one, you're going to be so disappointed.
So disappointed.
You're going to be so disappointed, God knows.
That's right.
Reign with him.
And shall reign with him 1,000 years.
1,000 years.
And when 1,000 years are expired,
1,000 years is over,
Satan shall be loosed out of the prison.
Here come the devil again.
And shall go out to deceive the
shall
nations.
Shall deceive the nations.
Which are in the four quarters.
Have you noticed the devil picked right up where he left off?
That's right. That's right.
Now, what is the devil manifesting? The greatest spirit of stubbornness.
That's right.
He was in bondage.
That's right.
And he wasn't deterred. Had no change of heart.
No, he didn't.
No change of mind.
That's right.
No change of attitude.
That's right.
The moment his sentence was over, he went right back doing the same work. Deceiving the nations.
That's right.
Whenever you hear the word of God and want to make a change, please don't think you impress the devil for wanting to change.
No.
He's going to do everything in his power to keep you from changing.
That's right.
You hear me preaching the word of God against cigarettes and smoking and drinking and clubbing and earrings and finger rings and fake fingernails and dyeing your hair and wigs and all that. Folks, hear me preach this from the Bible.
From the Bible.
So the devil make you blame me.
Yeah.
Put it on me. He a misogynist.
That's right. That's right.
He's nothing but a misogynist. He hate all the women. We don't know what woman done what to him. One woman said, he's the symbol of pure evil.
My Lord.
No, we just preach to you what your pastor wouldn't.
That's right.
See, there are many things the preachers won't preach because he know it'll make you mad and he won't get that money.
That's right.
I'm going to preach to you and don't care if you don't give up half of a penny. Amen. Let's more whole one. It That's doesn't right. matter if you don't give a half one.
That's right.
I'm going to tell you what the word of God say, whether you like it or not.
Amen. Preach it.
You might as well give it to make a change.
That's right.
May as well get ready to get rid of all your fingernail polish, toenail polish, and arching your eyebrows and all that stuff, and earrings all in your ear. Amen. Amen. And gold teeth all in your mouth. It don't make your smile more better.
No.
Either your breath still stink or it doesn't. Now, Pastor Jenny, you shouldn't have said that. Let me pull scripture. You got Bible for that? Give me the 17th chapter of the book of Job. Job 17 and
that's
1.
Right, that's right.
And let's see, did I make this up or does the Bible talk about
it? The Bible
says. You gold teeth, fancy smiling people.
Job chapter 17 and verse 1.
It don't make your breath no better.
No, it won't.
Hear the Bible.
Job chapter 17 and verse 1.
What is the testimony here?
My breath.
What?
My breath.
My breath
is corrupt.
Well, that's the end of that.
That's the end of that.
That's the end of that.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
So get all up in the mirror and brush your gold teeth and all that. And yeah, all right. Your stinking corrupt mouth.
Corrupt mouth.
You better take that mouth and get rid of that pride.
Appreciate
and that
it,
proud look and humble yourself under the mighty hands of God. That's because right. Hell gonna melt that gold in your mouth.
That's right. That's right.
You may as well come out of your mini skirts. You might as well. I'm partying for Jesus. No, you ain't.
No, you're not.
You're partying for the devil out of hell.
That's right.
If you don't come out of it now, you won't come out of it when you die.
Oh, yes.
Make the change that God wants you to make.
That's right.
And you'll have some self-dignity.
That's right.
You don't come out your door with halters.
No.
Showing your cleavage. Blouse cut way down like my jacket and no shorter than my jacket.
That's right.
You'll make a change.
Oh, yes.
You cover your body up.
Cover yourself.
Men to stop wearing booty shorts.
That's right.
And you're a man.
That's right.
Am I right?
Amen. Amen.
Man, listen. You ain't find nobody from the hood.
No.
When I was coming up.
No way.
Wearing booty shorts.
No way.
And you walking down the street.
No, no.
I mean, what are you, a male prostitute?
Go ahead.
Are you making a booty call from the hood?
From the hood. Amen.
See, the way the hood is now is not like it was when I was coming up.
No,
none of us brothers was wearing bangs.
No.
If we wore an earring in the ear, you was in a gang.
Right.
But men back then wasn't wearing two earrings, shaking their head like a Christmas tree.
That's right.
Like you some bogglehead on the dashboard of a car.
That's right.
We wasn't wearing our pants down.
No.
The common style, or back then we used the term the lay. The common lay was you wore your khakis, your leather belt with a reasonable size buckle, and you rolled your khakis up about three height with your high top old man comforts of Stacy Adams.
Yeah.
You may have your cool cap or straw Panama hat.
Yeah.
You know, you may wear a glove with the fingers cut out, but if you got a t-shirt that was rolled up on the end,
right,
you knew it was a man coming.
You knew it was a man.
Now you put that on. How you doing? How you doing? You just bouncing. You bouncing all around.
That's right.
What's wrong with you?
What's wrong with you?
See, in the hood, we had a thing called the line.
Yeah.
Most gangs had the line. And that is, the heavy hitters will form a line on both sides like the owl. And if you want to be a part of that game, you have to walk the line. And
right.
Each one take their time. Boom, 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 boom. I mean, they be pounding your body. And if you able to survive the line, you was in the game.
That's right.
It wasn't no drive-by shooting to get initiated in no game.
No, no.
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 You walk through the line now. How you doing? How are you? You walk in the line rubbing somebody. Hello. You understand?
That's right.
The manhood of the world.
Yeah.
The manhood of the world is under constant attack.
That's right.
By the devil. To snatch your manhood from you and make you look like a woman. Act like a woman. And even the women, the devil's trying to take away their feminine character. Want you to cut your hair like a man.
Like a man.
Have no switch, no twitch in your switch.
That's right.
Want to sit like a man. One leg east, one leg west.
Yeah.
It's a disgrace the way.
Yes, it is.
The human family have become, and religion is a contributing factor to the downfall of the men and women, because they're not teaching you nothing.
That's right.